most recent Twitter update reads, "I'm not asking to work in a movie church. I'm simply asking to work in an environment that is not a bastion of idiocy, noise, and spittle." Who said it? He's Mike Russel from The Oregonian, and he's today on Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. I am Rick Emerson, and welcome to Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. Perhaps as never before in our culture, the creators of, the audience for, and the commentators upon popular culture have found themselves brought together in one sort of contiguous mass. The boundaries and barriers between those three groups have all but evaporated, bringing them together as one living, breathing entity, one form of entertainment unto themselves. Pop culture has saturated our society to such a degree that it has, in effect, become almost the great secular religion of the 21st century. Joining us to talk about fan culture, film culture, and the media-obsessed nature of our fellow Portlanders is writer, essayist, and cartoonist for The Oregonian, Mike Russel. Hello, sir.
Hello.
No less an authority than Anthony Bourdain, who may in fact be the greatest human who has ever lived, said that Portland is a city of obsessives, that we are defined by our seemingly outsized interests in what might be perceived as niche things.
Yeah, we are a niche city. We are a city packed, jam-packed with niche interests. I've had personal experience with quite a few of them.
I think Homer Simpson actually once said that if you take two things that have never before been glued together and glued them together, there is in fact an audience for that. And Portland seems to be that way too. I think Anthony Bourdain talked about Velveteria, which is on, I think, Sandy, where it's an entire gallery of nothing but black velvet paintings.
Oh,
and Portland actually sustains this to such a degree that people can make a living selling, displaying nothing but black velvet. And so that, in a way, is a sort of microcosm of Portland, that people aren't just into things here, they are obsessed with things.
Oh, sure, yeah.
So we'll talk specifically about fan culture as it relates to Portland in a minute and film culture, but it's worth asking, is the fixation on pop culture, in your opinion, a recent phenomenon? It's hard to imagine, my dad, for example, going to like a Tinker Toys convention or something in 1968, the way that a Lego convention was at the Portland Convention Center just a few weeks ago, or
packed with people our age.
Packed with people yeah. our age, with money to spend, I might add. I walked in and it was just this endless panoply of Lego creations. I mean, just to the horizon, as far as the eye could see. I mean, clearly people with nothing better to do, or perhaps who did have better things to do but chose not to do them.
I think that's more accurate.
And it's also hard to imagine something like one of those VH1 shows where it's the procession of talking heads discussion about television programs. You can't really picture NBC having one of those in 1975 where a bunch of comedians talk about how great Gunsmoke was.
That's right,
but
yeah.
We have that here.
Gunsmoke fandom.
So what was the tipping point, in your opinion, where film fandom and pop culture became less of a hobby and more of an all-consuming interest?
I think that, frankly, we hit this perfect storm as a culture. I think it started, frankly, in the really obvious place, 1977, Star Wars. Almost, what now, 32 years ago?
32.
Almost to the day. And that debuted in theaters. I think that the perfect storm was that. I think like we were probably like 7 when that opened. And it caught a lot of people at just the right moment, and I think that began it. You certainly see a change in the trend of the kind of movies Hollywood makes. It goes from the very serious fare of the 70s that we were having and starts evolving more into the sort of pop entertainment, hero's quest-driven stuff. But the second thing is, I think, on a cultural level, we didn't have a war, a major war that sort of took the country's attention fully. And I think also we also had a lot of prosperity. I think basically when you put all that stuff together, you end up with a generation of people who have the leisure time and to actually go out and really get obsessed with Legos. I myself have a couple of Lego things sitting on my desk at home in my office.
Excellent.
Yes, thank you.
And in a perfect confluence of all things geektastic, one of the first things I saw when I walked in was actually a whole table of Firefly creations where they had made Serenity, or they made ships that were all sort of reavered out,
as
the young people say.
That brings up an interesting point, though, that you bring up Firefly fandom, which basically Portland is sort of the epicenter of that. Mm-hmm. I mean, Firefly and Serenity, there's a big charity effort now that's happened where a group of fans led by the one true Bix, who I believe you are acquainted with, have actually started a charity movement for Equality Now, which is a women's rights organization or a human rights organization focusing on abuses against women worldwide. And they've started this thing where they screen the movie Serenity every year, and the proceeds go toward toward Equality Now. Now that's interesting because you have people, the thing that Portland did right though is they took that very superfluous interest and then turned it into something that helps something meaningful, which maybe is what gives Portland the edge.
This is one of those things where I can tell we're in your wheelhouse, as they say. It was almost as the word Serenity or Firefly left your mouth, it was, you just...
Well, that's my expertise. I actually spent a lot of time covering Firefly and Serenity before the movie came out. That was sort of my beat as an entertainment reporter for a while.
And that maybe is a uniquely Portland thing, maybe not. Maybe Portland just has an advanced degree, the development that is happening in the culture at large, in that that could be your beat. What is essentially one single television show or one one set of television characters became, you know, the bulk of your reporting, the bulk of what you were talking about to readers, which I think wouldn't have been the case probably 20 years ago.
You can't
really imagine Carl Bernstein, you know, sort of beating the bushes to find out what was going to happen on Falcon Crest. It doesn't really seem like a thing that would have taken place in that era and has now, but I think in Portland to a much greater degree.
No, you definitely have probably more people today who can make their living as pop essayists. And who's that guy who writes the books about where he sort of said Billy Joel is awesome?
Chuck Klosterman.
Yeah, I mean, that guy, that career is a uniquely 21st century career. That man has a massive fan base for his essays about why Steely Dan is good, you know, or whatever he writes about. I've never actually read one of his books.
I think we've reached the point where all of the things that you were told would never pay the bills and things that you could never make a career at when you were going to school, you can now make a career at all of those things, I think, if you have the right sort of confluence of talent and drive and luck.
I actually, though, think, and this is interesting, I've spent a lot of time hanging out with sort of bohemian-minded folk, and one of the things I'm actually starting to see is because the economy's having a big poo, is that I'm starting to see that start to go away a little bit, and I'm starting to see a whole generation of my friends sort of freaking out about it.
Paying the rent business.
Right, yeah. I'm starting to wonder if that actually might have a shelf life with what's going on.
You know, I never really noticed the uniquely Ren Faire nature of your attire today until you said the word bohemian.
So oh, dear God.
I just need you to ask me, wouldst thou like a flagon of lemonade, sir? We come back, we'll talk about film culture as it relates specifically to Portland and some of the organizations that really have made a name for themselves supporting and being part of that rich movie tapestry. We're here with Mike Russel from the Oregonian. This is Outlook Portland. We return in just moments right here on Northwest 32.